Good morning, boys and girls. This is our Gospel for Kids, and today is the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And the Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to the tenants and went on in a journey. When vintage time came near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain the produce. But the tenants seized the servant, and one they beat, another they killed, the third they stoned. Again, he sent other servants more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease the vineyard to the other tenants, who will give him the products at the proper time." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures? The stone that the builders reject had become the cornerstone, but the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruits." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear boys and girls, you know, when I was a little boy, I loved to hear my parents reading stories for me, and my teachers, when it was time to read stories, was really fun time. You know, I remember some of them, some of those little stories: the three little pigs, Goldilocks, and three bears, the ugly duckling, the little red riding hood. And I know those stories, they're pretty old. Maybe you probably have your favorite ones, but those few that I remember, and was really, really fun to just to listen those stories. Do you know who was really good in tell us stories? Jesus. Jesus was pretty good in telling us stories, and the stories that Jesus he was giving to his people, and the stories that Jesus gave to us, called parables. Parables has a meaning because Jesus used parables with earthly examples, earthly material and earthly words to describe heavenly things. So that is the meaning of a parable. Using earthly things to describe heavenly things. Two different kinds of parable specifically that Jesus he always was giving to his people was one parable that we call window. And this window parable is when it's something like we are in a room, and we cannot see much, but when we open the window, then we can see much, much more. The other kind of parables that Jesus he used to give to us is we call mirror parables. So it's like you are looking at the mirror, and the mirror will give you your own image. So we can put ourselves in one of the characters of the parable, and we can see ourselves in those parables. Maybe you're gonna remember when the shepherd he find out that one of the sheep was stray, and he left the 99 and he was searching for the one that went stray. And when he found it, he got the sheep, put on his own shoulder, and brought back to the group. And this is a window parable because it's giving us the image of Jesus' Father, God, and was showing we are the sheep, we went astray, and we sinned. What God he does, he look for us, he find us, he doesn't punish us, but he with a love and kind way bring us back on his shoulders, and he reunite us with all the other ones. So this show us how our loving Father is a forgiveness Father and a merciful Father with such love and kind way to bring us back. And the parable that Jesus is giving us today is a mirror parable that we will see ourselves. We can put ourselves in one of the characters in the parable. When Jesus was giving this parable, he was giving to the religious leaders of his time. And Jesus was saying in this parable that was a landowner and he built a vineyard. And he gave this vineyard, he lent this vineyard to some tenants. They will cultivate the grapes, and when it was time for the crops, he will send someone, because the deal was to share the harvest, the crops. And this is what he did. But what they did, what the tenants did, they killed the first group. They beat, they kill, they put them away. The same they did with the second group. And they did this with to the son of the landlord. They did this to the heir. And they said, this is the heir, let's kill them and we can inherit all this for us. So we know that Jesus was talking about his Father that has this vineyard. And the Father wants to see if he will have the fruits. He sent the prophets. They killed the prophets. He sent another group of the prophets in the second covenant. They killed them. The Father, or the landlord, sent his only begotten son, Jesus, and they killed them. So we know what that means. That means that those religious leaders, they were the one that was not doing what they are supposed to do. Was this parable just for them, or is also for us? What can we learn here? First, we learned that God is looking for those fruits, our good actions, our good deeds. If we are not listening to his words, what we are doing? We are just kicking out all his messengers. And also, if we don't do what we're supposed to do, he will give this vineyard to the other tenants. And God, he gave this vineyard to the other tenants. He gave to the apostles. He gave to the church. So think about all those lessons, those teachings, and let's hear the word of God. Let's keep these words on our heart. Let's treasure on our heart those words. And let's do the best what we can to act on those words. You know, amazing things happens from little things. This is a good example that I wanted to share with you. In the Melrose Suspension Bridge is a bridge that cross the Niagara River and is in Buffalo and cross the Niagara River from United States to Canada. And this is the story how that is a suspension bridge, how that bridge was built. And this was with a kite. They were putting a kite on the sky, and the kite was with a string, and then the string was attached with a rope, and the rope was attached with a iron metal string. So that iron cable, to be honest, was something more powerful. And the kite flight to the other side, just with the string, attached in a string. And then they put the rope there, and with the rope, they also pull up the iron cable. And from there, they brought all the material they need to build that suspension bridge everybody uses today to cross from United States and cross the Niagara River to Canada and vice versa. From a little kite, they built that amazing bridge. From little stories, from little good actions that we have, love and kind actions, we can do things that we never imagine. We can do great, great things. Have a blessed day. Enjoy your Sunday. May the Lord bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.